And now with a Vladimir locked in, we're seeing a lot of picks that I do love in the hands of Rockhat players. Pyke as well, but Vladimir has been a key pick when Rockhat go into the late game where they would normally struggle. Vladimir brings so much damage to the table that they can often win out on those team fights. Now, that was in the hands of Prophet. HeQ hasn't had as much success, hasn't looked quite as comfortable, but Norskaren on this Pyke is something that always excites me.
Yeah, and a pick that can actually be proactive against Funnel Comp. We might get Heimerdinger coming in for the bottom lane together with most likely the Morgana, and then I'm looking at the Alistar as the funnel guy next to Kai'Sa on the side of Unicorns Love, so Cold would then be the Alistar player, and then you have this Heimer Morgana.
It's been a long one. Reset.
Turrets are down.
We have to keep our eyes on who's going to get it. Binding does connect. Cold immediately goes in. The follow-up CC is there. Ignite fired back from Norskaren. Just wants to get a bit of damage. Cold pull back in the middle of the team. That could be disastrous. Paddlestar
connects. No flash.
Ignite. Might just go down here. First blood from Memento. Neon Candy Strike back along with Exile. The Flash just to make it out along with the Smite to heal. Blanc looking to fire back shots. The Paddlestar connecting on the Unicorns of Love line. Ooh, Crimson Rush is going to be there.
Now.
Exile's in trouble. Binding does manage to connect, but it does not hit Memento, which means he's alive for now. Exile not running for his life. He does get level 2, but they're taking it back. Rockhat may not get the red buff, but the level 1 going greatly in their favor. Exile will see what else he can get. Memento is hovering, waiting in the wings here once he clears this Raptor camp. Has the Hextech ultimatum. Have to keep our eyes on that cooldown.
Oh,
that's a sleepy Kai'Sa. Oh, Memento wants it. Cold trying to buy a bit of time. The Ignite does go down onto Exile. He's ticking. Hookshot wall dive. Now trying to get a little bit more. Hextech ultimatum comes out. Can he take down Exile through the exhaust? He manages to get it. Everything going south. Cold going to flash over the wall. Challenging Smite comes in. A beautiful skewer to bring Cold back. White Knight in the middle of everybody. Wants to get one for the team. But what are you doing, man? There's too many people there. Looks like White Knight might go down as well. Blanc flashing out, a lot being used here just to chase this. Everything going wrong. Absolutely the case. Binding does manage to connect on Zoe. She goes out. She comes right back. Soul Shackle's going in as well, but that's not good news. That's a sleepy Morgana. She gets deleted by Blanc. Rockhat
looking for another play on top side. And
oh, White Knight.
Ah, the job.
That's the flag and drag. The flash committed for profit. White Knight, I don't think you can make it away from this, buddy. Wholesome, interactive champ, folks. Walk him down, making it look easy. And Totoro, that's a black shield, but it's not going to stop all that 80 from coming in. Neon, though, looking for the grenade. Firing some shots over the wall. Does take him down. First kill for the rookie on stage, but fired back on the side of Rockhat. Kai'Sa has a lot of ways to shred health. Challenging Smite coming out as well. Prophet does not care. Exile probably going to get the kill here, but very close. No ulti there along with the stopwatch. So a bit of a waste, but very close to getting the kill. Exile knocks him down in the end, and that's pretty much exactly what Unicorns of Love would want in that exchange.
It's important to highlight because of the 3 carries on Unicorns and not 4 supports. They're all actually starving for farm. Ideally, you want to give it to Exile. Let's see what happens, Prophet.
Sleepy White Knight. He flashes out, but it looks like it's just going to go right back down. Cataclysm tries to make it to safety, but you can't outrun the Hextech ultimatum. Rockhat grabbing the pick on the bottom side.
Starting to see some of the damage. Memento is around.
Ready, hookshot, wall dive. The stun does connect immediately. Hextech ultimatum. Exile trying to make his way out, but doesn't have an option yet. That's the power of the Vlad. Goes golden for a brief moment. Exile, can he make it to safety? The flash out. Tries to buy a bit of time. Exile not able to get anything more. Memento is there to make sure that Kai'Sa goes down. Neon does manage to go golden, but that's all she wrote, folks. Rockhat are cleaning up the fight. Prophet's just going to walk him down. White Knight able to get one back. Takes down the Pyke, but it's just a support. Has the flag and drag to make it to safety, but a beautiful fight from Rockhat. It's going to be all about the Baron. Unicorns
the Baron,
of Love.
Then.
Can they burn it down? Memento with no flash, but he has the smite up and available. Prophet making his way over. A bit of a split call here from Rockhat. No TP for the top laner means Unicorns of Love have the advantage for now. Blanc throwing out a bit of damage. 5k and dropping is the health of the Baron. Memento, you madman. Can you do it? 2k.
He's got
a little bit more. Can't do it. Neon getting it in the end. This is disaster for Rockhat, but HeQ trying to bring it back. Hits the Hemo Plague. Look at that damage. Vladimir not enough, however. Exile stands his ground and looks to fire back. Totoro wants to get something. HeQ still alive. I cannot believe
Exile?
It. Exile. This is the fight he needs, but Blanc says no despite everything. Looking like it could go in the favor of the Unicorns of Love. Blanc and the rest of Rockhat stand and are counted. Oh, are you?
Totoro. Almost in the end, but man, Unicorns of Love.
Memento though, 50%, Unicorns of Love could look for an opportunity here, but they just do not have the confidence to go in. And of course, it is an all or nothing gamble at this point. If they commit to a fight and lose, Rockhat instantly end the game.
Yeah, and you might as well take the fight before you lose 3 inhibs. That's kind of always the thing. A lot of teams end up sitting back, watch all 3 inhibs die, and then they decide, okay, maybe we need to do something. This might be it.
They're going to connect, puts Cold into the middle of the team. That's exactly what they want to get the fight started on the side of Unicorns of Love. But look at Exile's health bar. Damage blocked out there by the Black Shield, but HeQ kicking it off with that ultimate. Means that Rockadder is going to walk right in. Memento into the middle of everybody. Wants to get one kill down, but there's the Heimerdinger Tower in the middle of the team. White Knight running for his life. Memento is a madman, ready to walk into that fountain. Exile now running as well. He could just get taken down. Executed. Death from below. Rockat cleaning up this game just across the board. A beautiful performance. Unicorns of Love. They held on to hope for a brief moment, but in the end, it is Rockat who close it out. It is Rockat who play with their food, and Rockat who find the win.